Dear friends of SpiritTV, today I want to talk about trauma and techniques of erasing traumata. I think everybody knows about traumata. It can be psychic traumata or it can be body traumata. That means physical traumata like fractures or whatever. Every traumata releases a kind of mark in the body. That means a psychic trauma is something which we have to survive, and when we want to survive it, we suppress it. And these suppressed emotions can go into the body. That means they can even go down deep into the cell memory. And when they go into the cell memory, it makes it is one, in my opinion, one reasons why we develop organic diseases like cancer, degenerative diseases, and so on, maybe then 20, 30, 40 years later. It also can go into the so-called amygdala system, which is a technique which a good friend of mine, Dr. Charles Krebs, kinesiologist from Australia, developed. He said the amygdala system is the acute survive system. The amygdala are parts of the brain which are playing the main role in primary detection. That means if I walk around and I see a snake, I have stumbled and jump away. And that saves my surviving because I have to jump away even when I'm in Australia, that I'm not to be bitten, that I'm not bitten. And then I can see, oh, that was a harmless snake. That means when this amygdala system is activated by a trauma, which is all the time running and running and running, and that means, for example, people who were in the war and who were listening to the roaring thunders of grenades and of weapons and guns, then they have a program that even when they heard a burst or a loud sound from a car, then this amygdala system is always activated and they will think about the war. They can't sleep and so on. So it makes sense to erase or dissolve these patterns. A friend of mine in Germany, a good famous kinesiologist, is exploring or in his explorations or researches, he found out that the first impact or the first traumatic impact in the body, after his opinion, is taking place on the starting from the 19th day after conception. That means after semen and ova joined together to life. This is a time that is about 4 or 5 days after the woman is recognizing that her menstruation is missing. He comes to this time because at this time, this is the first time when special brain areas are going to develop in the fetus. And these brain areas are the areas where later on the emotions like anger, pain, not being self-confident, and so on are stored. Mm. So if the mother isn't happy because father is going to quit her, or she doesn't know how to survive financially, or what is happening to her future, then this can be the first program in the child, in mother's body. So it makes sense to work on this psychic traumas techniques. We call it the mental recall, and then with the mental recall we use some techniques which I will tell you in a second. If you have psychic traumas, if you have physical traumas, a physical trauma is boom, somebody hits me. It makes a big swinging in the whole body. So the swinging is or this rupture is going through the whole body. It even can make in the bone a kind of crystal lesion, or we call it a holographic lesion. For example, anybody knows when you're hitting your leg against a sharp edge of the bed, you can have pain for weeks and weeks and weeks, and the doctors tell you it's only the pain, I don't find anything, then there can be a lesion in the structure of the crystal structure of the bone. There are techniques where you use tuning forks, you put them on, and then these structural lesions are gone in a second. The applied kinesiology is using a technique, it's called the injury recall technique, where they want to take away the distension of the body just by using the ligaments of the cervix and the achillotendon, and to bring every disarrangement in the ligaments and in there they use a technique to bring a disalignment between the ligaments and the fascia. By using this technique. Now there are many techniques how you can erase traumata. One technique is called the EFT, that where you use acupuncture points of the yang meridians. When you test it with kinesiology, you tap on these points and let the people think about the trauma, and then the people will notice, oh, the trauma is going away. It also helps a little bit, up to a lot, with chronic pain. Then there is a eye movement disintegration technique. We know that when we have a trauma with the subconsciousness, we look with our eyes in the direction where it is stored in the brain, and when we let the people think about it, then we have to find out in which part where it is situated or laid down, and then we can make the people look or follow our eyes, and then they will notice that the imprint, the psychological imprint, is going to weaken. My special favorite technique is a technique which my wife and I developed. I call it the color erasing technique. And that means if you think about a trauma, and please start not with the worst trauma you had in your life, because even when you're alone and no therapist is around, that you can close your eyes, think about the trauma with all the senses, with the smell, with the hearing, with the voice, with whatever you have. Yeah, you pace it with all your senses. And then put all the information, and then think about a color, and put all the information in a kind of basket, and then combine the basket visually with the color, and then think about the color as long as you can. And then when the color is then going to glow away, to disappear, then all the emotions disappear with the color. You can transform it into love and light, into the next sun, whatever you do. But you will notice that a lot of the stress is going to be reduced with that. In my opinion, it is very, very necessary to erase old traumas because of the self-producing, we call it devil circles in Germany, where our conditioning is getting worse and worse and worse. When from fear it goes to fear in the darkness, fear in the elevator, to fear in a tunnel, and so on and so on. And you have to erase the original trauma, otherwise you have a big point of becoming, or a big reason to become very sick someday.